Handball Show. In the last episode, we concluded our one-wall action from the Nationals at Brafey House Sports Arena, and this time we bring you the traditional Irish game of 60 by 30 handball. The All-Ireland Senior 60 by 30 Singles Championship is seen as the blue ribbon event, and for 86 years has seen some of the greatest Irish sportsmen lay claim to the illustrious honour. Joey Marr, Dick Ling, Pat Kirby and record breaker Duxie Walsh have been labelled amongst the all-time greats of the game, and in this episode we will see another as Dublin's own Kennedy goes in search of an incredible 8th consecutive All-Ireland Senior Singles crown. Before that, however, we look at some of the rising young stars of the game. The All-Ireland Minor Singles Championship saw Martin Mulcairn's bid to join an elite group of players who secured two in a row in the series. Abby Lara provided the venue as the Galway teenager faced Kildare's Niall O'Connor in a fascinating final showdown. Mulcairn's exhibited tremendous accuracy in the first to win 21-14. And despite some precision shooting from O'Connor, the Galway man retained the edge in the second. The 21-11 win in the second saw Martin Mulcairns become the 10th player in history to win back-to-back minor honours. The intermediate doubles final in Abby Lara provided a unique clash involving Roscommon and Meath. Gary McConnell's long-range kill shot saw Meath enjoy a decisive edge as they ran out convincing winners in the opening game by 21-4. However, the battling qualities of Roscommon's Angus Cunningham and Chris Doolan soon came through. A dramatic encounter unfolded in the second, and a 21-19 win for Roscommon saw them level the match.
You know, these are vital points as well. Like, you know, they'll be fighting for these at the end of the game, so they really should be aware of that.
That's right. Every point's crucial, whether it's the beginning or end of a match. They all add up at the end.
I think so, yeah.
And the Scommon really were on a high at the end of that second game. Now, can they carry that over into this third game?
Good shot.
And that's good play from Magnus Cunningham there.
Good point, there.
So the Scommon getting a stronger position here all the time in this third game. And now, we talked all throughout the match, Paul, about how would Roscommon respond to the challenge, and now it's all about how Meath is going to respond to the challenge.
Exactly, yeah, so.
Because this is a big challenge here in an Ireland final here, Paul. Third game, big crowd, and you've won the first game easily in the case of Meath. Suddenly, the pressure's on. Roscommon are missing nothing at the minute. They're making every shot.
Exactly, they're kind of playing safe, but you know, they're going to eventually, at some point, they're going to have to go for it. Go for the elder. They've had some shots here. They're probably playing smartly at the minute, you know.
Yeah, they're playing smart, humble at the minute. Roscommon, they're not attacking the game. They're happy enough that the game is ticking over nicely for them at the minute. The way they're playing. There's a good shot there. Great shot. Excellent. Passing shot down the right hand side.
From that point, the Roscommon duo held the edge and took control before running out victorious.
I'm absolutely speechless, really, because I didn't really ever think I'd get to the stage, because you probably remember I played yourself when we were youngsters, and I gave up handball for many years after, and I only came back to kind of stay fit. But lucky enough, I had a very young, fit, brilliant handballer beside me here who covered all the ground that I couldn't cover anymore, you know. And thankfully, he decided to team up with me this year, and we said we'd give it one go. And I'm absolutely thrilled to bits now. Absolutely thrilled. Cannot express it even, quite honestly.
Before we focus on the ladies' decider and the keenly contested men's open singles championship semi-finals, we firstly travel to County Clare and the club of Tuam Graney, home of one of the all-time legends of the game. Pat Kirby won four All-Ireland senior singles titles in succession from 1974 to 1977.
You know, this is where it all started. 70 years ago, I played in that big court in there as a little toddler, and that's where I honed my skills and went from there. The guy that ran the handball at that particular time, he's dead now. His name was Michael O'Neill. He would fill both pockets with candies, or sweets as we called them back then. And he would make a doubles partnership of six or eight or ten of us. We'd all play each other, and the winner's got two sweets. That was the prize. And that's what kept it going. I mean, it was, you know, we were all striving to beat each other to get the two candies or the two sweets. And we were emulating the senior players and the better players that played in here. And they basically taught us the fundamentals, and we went from there and added whatever we could. Then I departed for America and I learned a lot about the game over there. Then when I came back in 1972, I was teased and teased and teased that I never would have seen All Ireland. And of course, I don't take teasing very easily. So the nerve, you know, hit, and I got mad and I said, I'm going to win All Ireland. So at that stage in 1974, I said, okay, 38 years of age, I'm going to beat all these guys that are talking here about Kirby didn't do this, Kirby didn't do that. And for the next 4 years, I monopolized. And basically, it was all with me, psychology and fitness. That's how I beat all these guys.
Back when we were young, like the Kirbys and the Hogans and the Walshes and all them, it's kind of like you'd be playing away kind of thing, and you'd be kind of imitating it. You're one of them kind of. Pat Kirby was obviously the best, like we say, but John and Dan and Michael Hogan, me, Holly Hogan there would have won multiple senior titles. I think the Kirby's between all of them have 100 All-Ireland titles, like, which is crazy stuff.
The club is very strong. At juvenile level, we have over 100 kids, boys and girls, right from under 8s right up to 17, 18, and then they move on into the adult grades. On the adult scene, we have 40 adult members. Our top two players are Dermot Nash and Niall Malone, who have achieved senior status this year by winning the intermediate 40 by 20 doubles. So the future is bright.
I'm honoured to be standing here and talking about Tuam Graney Handball Club, and standing here in front of the castle, where as a child I first saw handball being played and the ball being served off the row that time against the wall. And to move on to where we're at now, it's absolutely fantastic. It's a dream come true. You could spend the rest of this day talking about Pat Kirby and his achievements, but the good of Pat Kirby was that he never forgot where he came from. And Pat was the man that drove us to achieve what we have achieved and to be where we are today. We never forgot it. Not alone did it take Tuam Graney handball into another level, but it took Irish handball to another level.
It's a wonderful occasion. What a great occasion for the people of East Clare here, and celebrating here this evening with the Tulla Pipe Band and Pat Kirby and all the Kirby family and all the people that have been involved with handball over the years. 100 years of it here. William MacLeod gave the handball court here and put it up 100 years ago, so it's great to have a 100 year celebration.
And 2011 saw his renowned club celebrate their centenary year with the launch of a statue in his honour.
That means a game that you played off the gable of houses. And long before there were 40s by 20s or 60s by 30s or anything, the gables of the houses were there, and that was the origin of handball. Tashe on the ace that fought is quite a old, okay? I was confirmed at Pat. Somebody said he played at a higher standard. I saw him play. I had the privilege of broadcasting hurling games that he played in. Not alone was he very good, but he did everything with style, and you need only take one look at that. One hand towards heaven, almost reaching it, the eye on the ball, and we all know the result.
I think it was 81, 82, Pat was retired for 3 or 4 years, and he came back and he played Tom O'Rourke, which was All-Ireland champion and world champion, in Clonmel. He lost just by a couple of points in the third game, and if he had to win, he would have to been retired for 3 or 4 years, coming back and he would have won it again.
I'm very glad, he just mentioned I was gone, I'm very glad I was gone. I've been running around after this young little guy. That wouldn't be, not so much fun. He took over the mantle and fair play. He's really brought it up to date. And he's more All-Ireland than the whole bunch of us together. Great player, good sportsman, a good Kilkenny man.
Ladies 60 by 30 handball has grown in stature also in recent times, with a number of major contenders emerging. The All-Ireland Ladies Doubles Final provided a treat too. Reigning champions Kerry's Maria Daly and Ashley Prenderville were favourites to win.
Maria Daly serving for Kerry. They're in a very strong position here at the minute. And that's up, and that's and that's a very welcome shot for the Mayo guys. We're glad to see that one.
But found themselves in an epic clash with Pauline Gallagher and Amy Corrigan.
They've done it! What a victory! What a point!
Brilliant!
What a remarkable victory for Mayo, All-Ireland Senior Ladies Doubles Champions. Owen, what a performance, what a finish.
In the end, the title went to Mayo for the first time following a thrilling three-game encounter.
Nothing went right for us really today, and you know, sometimes you have those kind of days. But in fairness to Pauline and Amy, they really worked together well as a team, like, and I think just Marie and myself found it difficult to get the ball back behind them today, you know, and they were taking off there, and sometimes you just have to lose. We've tried for a long time, you know, to really push for this and get up the ladder. So phenomenal players, singles, hands down, they beat me and they probably beat Amy too. But in doubles, you know, we really worked on our communication to make us that bit stronger, and it seemed to pull off today. But like, you know, the training that we put in seemed to have pulled off. But other than that, like, it's fantastic to see the women, you know, getting the kind of, you know, promotion and all the rest that it has got, and hopefully now the young ones will start coming up as well. And, maybe be an inspiration to them or something like that.
Join us after the break when we will focus on the men's Open Singles Championship event with some of the most exciting action from the year in the sport.